Hello, Adam Rayner, Talk Audio TV, and welcome to the third in a series of seven little videos, which are unboxings and, because of YouTube rights issues, the shortest little samples of music with, seven different sets of 6.5 or 6.75 inch speakers. These are the from the Kicker manufacturer. We've got three pairs from them, each with, funnily enough, seven digits in their part number, and they're only separated by one single letter. We've had the DSC674, which stands for 6.5. Anyway, the whole point is there's the DSC, the CSC, and the KSC. These are the CSC. We've already looked at the D's, and these are just a penny less than 70 quid. Here's the box. Let's let you have a little shift here. That 300 watt is a pretty serious peak rating, so divide that by half. 150. Divide that by half again. Ooh, 75 watts. Now, what's the actual power RMS on here? Let's have a little shifty. Whoop. Continuous power RMS, 100 watts. So basically, that 300 watt peak has been calculated a whole load more sensibly than other people's. These are obviously made not just for improving on amplifier. Sorry, not just for. Look, I'll start that again. These are obviously made not just for improving on the head unit's amplifier output by having greater efficiency, but these are equipped to take more power properly, amplifier power, 100 watts. That's a lot of actual wattage. Making heavy weather out of this again. La la la, proves I haven't opened them before. Here we go. I've opened both ends, but in actual fact, we're looking at a classic two-box pod thing here. No? Push that out there. Is it one piece of card? It is. Here we go. I'll just pop the box over there. They're stuck together is the plot. We do have the classic two separate card wrap things. Something has fallen down floppy plop. I think it may well be this. This is a particularly kicker part. It's just as well as the spec sheet. Let's put the spec sheet so as to give you the chance of the 4K seeing what these are. If it fills the lens, it should focus better. These are decent little chunks of cable. And the thing that just fell down would be the little red crimp connectors. I was right. It could only be. That's a decent connector, which, as I've said before, a good crimp causes a micro weld at the point of mega squeezing, which is actually better than a bit of solder. Here we have the little pack of parts as well, because you always get basically some clips and screws for mounting the thing in the ironmonger if that's all you have. I've got a couple of lovely MDF enclosures. Interesting, here we go. These look an awful lot like the other product. Similar plastic grill that goes over a cute little... it says CSC. I'm thinking, these are just like the ones I've just taken out. They look remarkably similar. They too have a nil protrusion tweeter. Fairly decent little load of stuff on the back. Obviously, I've been getting on about the one digit and how confused I've been getting about from one product to the other. These are in the same chassis. The sticker looks almost the bloody same. I was thinking, these are similar. They are intended as a drop-in replacement, but what they are is a higher power product. The specification is identical in every single way, except until you get to a couple of crucial things. First, these are 3.5 ohms, not 4 ohms, nominal impedance. Because at 3.5 ohms, that means these show a lower resistance than a normal speaker and will be even louder because they're just as efficient at 90 decibels per watt you put in for whatever power you do have in the head unit of your car. So the reason these are more expensive, because I was looking for that, is that not only will they go louder on less power for only 3.5 ohms of nominal impedance, but also they will actually go louder on more amplifier power, because this is the specs for the DSC. This is the specs for the CSC. And I could get all geeky and go, look, here it says. But the real difference is that instead of... 60 and 240 being the maximum and peak, we've got 100 and 300 as the power ratings. And that is all about what's going on inside this motor. We've seen this motor on the other product. It's a powerful looking piece of kit. Can I get the light in and around so you can see the spider in there? Just a bit, hang on, ooh, there we go. My face. Anyway, the whole point is we need to plug these into the stand and see how well they work compared to the others. This is going to be a little challenging because basically they're a very similar speaker. They're almost identical. Let's see if I can tell any difference. Reviewer boy. A little bit of preparation was necessary there. I've taken the little specification sheets for both series of loudspeakers, highlighted the two models I have, and, well, you can see circled the only single differences in the specifications. This is why I just look so puzzled and a bit confused. I've also said 3.5. It's 3.3 ohms. Got a funny story. I was testing some 6x9 loudspeakers. I was doing it on domestic equipment. I had some Rockford Fosgates. Wow, were they loud. Then my home equipment blew up, and that was when I realised that I looked at the specification. They were only 3 ohms. They were just too low in impedance to allow my amplifier not to kill itself. And, well, frankly, yes, that's exactly what happened. Oh, sorry about the facing, too big a close-up. However, we'll leave it there because I'm going to reach down and grab hold of the speaker again. This is the CSC. They call it 6.7 because it's 6 3/4. To me, that top roll suspension looks like it might be a tiny bit stronger. I don't know. But basically, this is looking almost identical to the previous unboxing video in terms of what was in there. But the big difference is what's in the guts of this here motor. The coil, I think in an essentially similar piece of ferrite, has just got more metal. It's more expensively made. There's more grip to it. And yet it's been wound to be only 3.5 ohms and yet hold 100 watts. At this small size speaker, it's able to do more than it's supposed to be able to do because it's more efficient, yet higher power. And that flies in the face of speaker physics, Captain. It's only 100 watts, but it does go to show how really efficiently made these speakers are. Look at the nice thickness of the cable going around the bottom of there. And the fact that it's serial numbered individually means that it's a proper piece of kit. So, $69.99, the CSC 674 or 6704. You're reading it on the specs from Kickout. Right, let's go and plug it into the system and see what we think. Okay, let's try this on camera. It's testing time. So, we take hold of the heap of cables here. Simply go, wallop. Ooh. Is this stuff happening? The light's a bit on here. Amplifier's coming on. It's a bit of FM. Bless it. Can I hear a disc whirring? I've broken the display on this. The transport noises. Whoa! Here we go. I think that should be what I wanted. No, it isn't. There will be a jump edit here. I want to find this track, baby.
Diamond in the flesh. I cut my teeth on wedding rings in the movies.
I wonder how much I was in the way of that. Perhaps the microphone wasn't straight. Right, let's just try a little there. Oh, an awful noise there, haven't I? Let's just put it right in the middle. Zoom back, see if I've got any. Because, of course, there is the other one there. Let's just have a little zoom in on there. Let's face it, we're sure that the sound quality through my camera is only going to be of limited quality to really enable you to tell. But there it is. That's the Kicker CSC 6.7 4 ohm. So 6 3/4 inches, 4 ohms. That particular one, 70 quid rather than 50. It's got more bass in its guts, basically. Okay, let's just have another little moment See if you can actually hear any fidelity going on here. Actually, let's move the camera properly in between the speakers. There should be a nice central image. I spent a lot of money on that microphone.
I've never seen a diamond in the flesh. I cut my teeth on wedding rings in the movies.
Wow. Let's try another little bit, just a little tiny bit of medium volume.
Uptown, no postcode envy.
I'm pretty sure I've overmodulated that. We'll try again, have another little bit. I can jump cut and hopefully get one of these that works.
Hotel room, we don't care. We're driving Cadillacs in our dreams.
Well, so there we go. That's all she wrote for fear of getting much of the copyright strikes from good old YouTube. This is Adam Rayner signing out for Talk Audio TV with the kicker CSC674. Thanks very much. Highly recommended, by the way.